What's up, everybody? I'm back with another one. Let's see what is happening for this full moon. What is happening during this full moon, Holy Spirit? What will happen? Damn, I cut the deck on the Five of Wands. Let's see, Holy Spirit. I believe it's a full moon in Leo, Holy Spirit. But what is the message regarding the full moon and the energy surrounding this full moon, please? And thank you, Holy Spirit. What is it that you would like for us to know about the full moon and what's happening? Insight and guidance, please. And thank you, Holy Spirit, from you through me. Let's go, y'all. Full moon energy, Holy Spirit. Eight of Pentacles. Ace of Pentacles. Whatever someone is choosing to invest in during this full moon, they are not going to get what they received. Ace of Pentacles then came out here in reverse, child. Y'all seen that? Page of Swords. I feel like this person thinks they have all of the information needed to move forward with this action here, but they're missing a puzzle piece. And that's the Most High with this Hierophant energy. They're missing some type of spiritual decree that's already been decided and given regarding what this is that they're trying to change or invest in. Okay? But they don't want to listen to what they've been told. It may be a King of Cups, or it could be, I don't know. Clarify this King of Cups energy here. I feel like this King of Cups has been told, already received. Why? Ooh, y'all saw how that card. Did y'all see that? That card was standing up just like this by itself for a minute. I don't know if you caught that. I don't know if anybody caught that. We have the Nine of Swords. This King of Swords has been warned, has learned, has been told that whatever this is that he keeps investing into is not going to produce the results that he wants. It's not going to make the change happen that he wants to happen. But he continues to invest, and he's going to be in the Nine of Swords if he goes any further with this, if he continues to try to manipulate this situation in any way. He gonna be juggling more than he thought. He's most definitely biting off more than he can chew here. What else, Holy Spirit? The World. I'm trying to tell you, with justice. So we got a King of Cups who is dead set on investing his energy and efforts into some type of behavior during this full moon. What exactly is this that this King of Cups has been warned not to do, yet he still continues to try anyway? Holy Spirit. Eight of Swords, trying to spiritually trap somebody. Five of Pentacles. An Empress, child. Ow, child. This don't even make no type of sense, child. This is comical at this point. Because what? How you keep getting blasted by the universe and you still keep trying to do this type of shit against the divine feminine? But you keep getting blasted in various ways. But you still keep trying to spiritually trap this divine feminine and have her in the Five of Pentacles. Child. So this is a King of Cups plan for this full moon, y'all. He trying to trap somebody up. He trying to get him fucked up, boy. He trying to fuck. Look, you see how she pouring that water out that shell? That's how that spirit, that spiritual warfare is going to flow right on out of her, right past her. Okay. Why is this King of Cups and this energy towards this Empress, Holy Spirit? Five of Cups. sorrow, tears, and blood. This man is in regret about this woman. Sorrow, tears, and blood. We have the Queen of Wands. I feel like this man is in regret that he could not keep this woman on a certain level. Look at this snake around her neck. A Queen of Wands is an empress in training. Someone who has all the qualities of a divine feminine. Not saying she's not utilizing those qualities, but she hadn't quite really tapped into her true element yet. She's getting an idea of herself. She's really independent of what people think and feel of her. She's intuitive, but she still got these type of karmic energies hanging around her neck, okay? And that's that King of Cups, that snake energy. This man isn't regretful, though, because he could not keep this empress in that vibe. He could not keep her on that level. She has truly evolved. She's truly transmitted this energy. We got the Queen of Pentacles with the Knight of Wands. And we got the King of Pentacles, child, right behind that. She's evolved. And I feel like it's one of them, y'all. This King of Cups is intuitively picking up that this Queen of Pentacles, Empress energy, she coming as the Queen of Pentacles, Queen of Wands with the Empress. She's about to meet a divine, her divine counterpart here. That's why his ass in the Nine of Swords. The King of Pentacles is falling right up underneath the Nine of Swords. This woman is about to receive her divine counterpart. So tonight is the night to try to stop. That's what he's trying to stop with this Ace of Pentacles in reverse. But I'm telling you too, he's trying to stop this divine partnership. But I'm telling you, it's not going to work out the way he thinks. The change that he's trying to make is not going to come to pass. We have the Page of Cups. This man is still going to make an offer to this Empress here. And this King of Cups going to be heartbroken because these people are going to... This some past life soulmate type of shit right here. These people finna connect. This man has intuitively picked up, whether it's through spiritual spying or whatever the hell he doing, because he doing something. But he know this woman about to get her divine counterpart, and he trying to stop it with this Ten of Swords and the Seven of Pentacles. Oh, he trying to stop it. But he going to be stopped, though, y'all. That's, you know, that's already out here. The scale's going to be balanced here. Clarify, Holy Spirit. Child. Seven of Cups. He got some far-fetched wishes, if you ask me what I'm picking up. What else? Six of Pentacles. This man won't, this woman is still giving, give to and receive from him. It's really giving, like, this woman really turned into a whole, like, trick, whole empress in reverse type energy when she fucked with this King of Cups. She become one of his best sluts, okay? I'm just going to keep it a buck. That's why I'm getting irritated, because this man wants to have this woman reside in some type of low vibrational behavior to stroke his ego when this woman has truly done the work, left whatever type of energy she was in with this man behind, and she trying to be a better woman. She really has changed. That's what I'm getting here, okay? And this man is trying to stop her from being an honest woman. It's literally what I'm getting, y'all. Knight of Swords, death. He trying to stop her. He trying to stop her from Ten of Wands with the Seven of Swords. Come on now. He wants her to give up this divine femininity that she has embraced within herself. He wants her to go back to satisfying his needs in whatever way she was doing that. And I'm telling you, this woman was compromising herself to deal with this King of Cups. He was that snake around her neck. So tonight, his ass finna do some damn spell work. he finna participate in some hermit ass roguish behavior so that he can be her damn, she can be with his ass. I'm telling you, it's some type of control. Like this King of Cups, he coming out as her. He want, look y'all, now this masculine, he want to be with this Empress, but he don't want to be with her like he know he gotta be with her or he should be with her. He knows he should boss up and be with this Empress, but this King of Cups wants to have authority over her. This is what this emperor energy is about, okay? He don't want to be her equal. He don't want to be, he don't even want to be her divine masculine. He don't want to be her partner like that, okay? He want to rule over her. He want to slut her out. I'm telling you what I'm picking up on, y'all. I'm telling you. Clarify, Holy Spirit. That's what this emperor energy is about. He want to establish some type of law and order over her life. Queen of Swords. This man ain't fucking with her like that. Not like this King of Pentacles will be, who's about to enter her life and make her an offer here. He trying to stop that. He trying to do something where she will be dealing with him to the point where she's not going to be even available to receive this offer from this King of Pentacles. He don't have no respect for this woman. He want to use her. And that's just period. The Magician. He's only taking action with her to manipulate things the way that he wants them to be. He ain't taking action to make her happy or satisfy any of her wants and needs in any way. Like, this is wild. Page of Pentacles. But I'm telling you, it's not going to work out how he wanted to work out. That's what I was picking up from the very beginning. And whatever he's trying to do, those offers are not going to be accepted by the universe, okay? This Empress don't deserve for this King of Cups to be coming for her like that. And what's crazy is this man love her. Y'all got to stop fighting against them emotions you feel for somebody and to truly embrace them, examine them, understand why you feel so strongly for them. Not try to manipulate them or destroy them. Or make their life hard. It's almost like, oh, you love me? Oh, I love you? It's got to be something wrong if I love you. It's got to be something wrong with you if you telling me you love me and you like me and you want to do right by me. Oh, you got something up your sleeve. You got a plan with this Knight of Swords. I'm unable to decide about you and see you for who you truly are. So, like most people do, they leave these connections behind. They pass judgment. They turn their back to the people that they're supposed to be in these divine partnerships with. But that comes from underlying trauma that has not been addressed or released. Okay? Because I'm really picking up something like that off of this King of Cups. They're now coming out here as a King and Queen of Cups. And a king, an emperor and an empress. So there's some type of karmic soulmate type of vibe between these people. But this King of Cups, he just don't want to accept that that's who she is. He wants to see her in some type of slut vibe, y'all. 1440 woman, I looked up, I'm telling you. He do not want to give this woman the respect that she deserves. It's almost like he refuses. And she's not playing into that anymore. She used to allow him to utilize her and use her in that way. But she ain't doing that shit no more. She has evolved from that, and he's trying to pull her back down to that. And it's also because he can pick up that there is someone who's about to give her the honor and respect that she deserves, this King of Pentacles. He mad about that shit. So I don't know. What's going to be the outcome? Well, we see already. I keep saying that because this is his adamance that what he's about to do is going to work tonight. He's sure that he's going to be able to make this woman fall from grace and return back to this low vibing Queen of Wands energy that he had her wrapped up in. We got the Wheel of Fortune. I'm telling you, he's trying to change fate heavy. This Wheel of Fortune is falling right up under the Magician. That's why I keep saying what's going to happen. But I feel like it's fated for this woman to be with this King of Pentacles. Can I get more insight on this Queen and King of Pentacles, Holy Spirit? Three of Cups, child. I'm trying to tell you because this King of Cups ain't acting right. He on some old other shit. So the universe has rearranged some things. So this Divine Feminine can get the divine counterpart that she deserves. And these people are going to have success. They're going to be in the Six of Wands and the Nine of Cups along with the Three of Cups. Okay? He know that shit. High Priestess. With the Two of Wands, I'm telling you, this man been spiritually spying on this Divine Feminine here. He knows what the universe holds for has for her and this man. This is why he's doing this. He want her to be his slut. I am telling you. King of Wands with the King of Swords with the Knight of Cups. That is the future that he has planned for them. He ain't trying to have it no other way with this woman. Even though, again, he has feelings for her. He cares for her. Ain't nobody fucking doing all this shit behind nobody that they don't fuck with or that they wish they could be around. Who finna put all this energy into a woman that they don't care nothing about? That's why I said he got some healing to do. Because his perception of what love is and what he feels for this woman is warped. He fucking think it's something, it should be something sordid instead of something beautiful and happy and peaceful. Okay, that's the problem here. This is her energy. This is what she brings to the table. Not what he's trying to put her in. But this is what she's going to remain. Despite his future plans for her. She's still going to remain in the sun. Okay? Anything else, Holy Spirit? Any final messages, please and thank you? Seven of Wands. I'm telling you. What he about to try to do tonight, that shit finna be blocked. And this King and Queen of Pentacles are gonna have their new start together, okay? And I'm gonna end it here. I hope this message helped someone. I hope it gave you insight and clarity. But always remember, y'all, if it doesn't apply, please let it fly. Take only what resonates, leave the rest, and I'll be back soon with another one. Peace, y'all.